I'm unable to connect to the side chat right now. All right, can everyone see me? I cannot see your guys' chats at the moment, so I'm just gonna pull it up down here on my device. You guys are doing and see who's all on here. I'm in a garage. We have cardio, core, and boxing together. So to get us started, if this is your first time, welcome. My name is Brittany. I'm gonna be your guide for the next 25 minutes. So we're gonna go through some cardio and some core with me, and then I'm gonna hand it off to Teddy, and he's gonna take you through some boxing. Right now, the only thing you need is an open mind, an open heart, and just, you know, just a good attitude. We're gonna get right on into this. I'm gonna go to the live chat right here so I can see. Okay, so it looks like we have Amber, Irene, Alyssa, Connie, Donia, Tyler, what's going on? I just saw your band purchase. Rin, hello, Striving Uplift, Janice, Donica, Taryn, Erica, what is going on? Kira, hey Kira, Erica Welsh. All right, so now that I have everybody on here, I just can't see it on my laptop, so I'm gonna use my viewfinder down here. Let's go ahead and get you guys going through a nice and easy warm up. So we're gonna start with some mobility. Go ahead and lift that right foot off the ground. You're gonna give me ankle circles. Three ankle circles in each direction. Good, go ahead and take it in the other direction. There you go. Go ahead and take that foot down. We're gonna take this, go ahead and lift up your right foot, left foot. Three ankle circles in each direction. Same thing, same vibe. Take it in the other direction. Yes, there we go. Go ahead and take those feet out wider than shoulder width apart. I'm gonna have you just kind of push your hips back. And as you push your hips back on your right foot, I'm gonna have you kind of turn your foot down towards the ground and switch sides. So we're really working on stretching out one of those abductors, so the inner thighs there. And so just kind of sway from side to side. Good. One more on each side. There we go. Go ahead and step together, feet together. Bend your legs, bring your hands on top of your knees. Give me some knee circles, kind of like a tootsie roll, you know? Good, go ahead, take it in the other direction. There we go, go ahead and sit up nice and tall. Reach your hands out in front of you, give me your wrist circles. So with me, we're gonna do some cardio. So if you're used to working out with me, I usually do 3x3 blocks. Today we're going to do some 60 second pushes. We're gonna do cardio core. Go ahead and take it in the other direction. So we're gonna get really sweaty, and then we're gonna do a nice little finisher. We're gonna do a nice little finisher with Teddy. Good, now go ahead and take those hands up and down. So if you're painting a wall in front of you, fingertips are paintbrushes. Take those hands up and down, and here's your moment to kind of groove. I always say come as you are, check where you are today. Hey, good, go ahead and take those hands inside to side. Just opening up the chest, whoo, there we go. Nice, now go ahead and take those hands out. Keep your elbows where they are. Fan towards your face, as if there's something in front of you and it smells really yummy, and you're fanning it in towards your face. Good, now go ahead and fan away. That's my easiest way to describe it. Good, one more. Nice, take those hands out. One hand up, one down. Go ahead and open up the chest. Oh, snap, crackle, pop. Snap, crackle, and pop right here. Good, so all you're doing is one hand comes down, opening up the chest, the other one comes up. Let's do this one more on each side. Whew. We have a lot of chest, a lot of shoulders, a lot of core. Go ahead and take those hands down. Stack your feet right underneath you. Give yourself a big hug. Lean over to the right side of the room. Fall forward, bend your legs. Whew. Two big hip circles in each direction. Fall again, forward to the right. Now let's take it over to the left side. Left, fall forward. Good, come on up tall. Let's do it again, fold forward, nice. Go ahead and come on up, there we go. Now go ahead and just kind of shake it out. Give me your little dance, whatever your groove is. Take those feet out wider than shoulder width apart, all right? So now I'm gonna be toe out. Now I want you to come down and find your deepest squat. Your deepest squat could be here, your deepest squat could be down here. I'm gonna have you bring your elbows in the inside of your knees. I'm just gonna have you pry those hips open, just rocking side to side right here. Big tall chest, try to keep your chest up nice and tall, as high as you possibly can. Good. Now from here, I'm gonna have you make contact with the ground, right? So you can still do this here, but on top of your knees, you don't have to touch the ground. Go ahead and lift your left hand up to the sky, stare at your left fingertips, take that left hand down, same thing on the other side, right hand comes up, stare at those right fingertips, take it down. Switching sides, one more. Come on up, take it down, and finish here. Good. Now from here, I'm going to have you keep your hands on the ground. I'm going to have you crawl out to a high plank. Crawl out to a high plank. Good. So now, in this high plank position, make sure everything is stacked. Shoulders, elbows, wrists. You should be able to draw a nice long line. Fan out those fingers. Get an equal distribution of weight in those fingertips. Go ahead and push your hips back. Find a down dog. Pedal out your heels. So all you're doing is bending your knees and dropping your heel down to the earth. Good. And breathe. Big inhale through your nose. Exhale out your mouth. Now from here, I'm going to have you come on down. Come up to up dog. Rest on the top of your thighs. Untuck your toes. Pull your shoulders back. Push your body up away from the ground. And let your head tick-tock side to side. There you go. We're going to do this again. Tuck those toes. Push your booty back. Down dog. Pedal out your heels. Nice. Pedal out those heels, pedal out those heels. Just check in with your body, creating a little bit more length of the hamstring calves. Come on forward, up dog, untuck your toes. Pop them down, let your head tick-tock side to side. There you go. We're gonna do this one more time. Are you guys ready? Here we go, down dog. Good, heel down, heel down, heel down. Go ahead and come back, dive forward. Lift up nice and tall, roll your shoulders back, and let your head tick-tock side to side. Way to go. Whew. Now from here, keep your knees where they are. Walk your hands so they're stacked right underneath those shoulders. Now I'm going to have you give me a great big inhale. Round your spine, lift your head up to the sky, and exhale. Push the ground away, drop your head down, squeeze your glutes. So let's do this again. Inhale in, lift your chest. Exhale, push the ground away. We're going to do this again. Inhale in. And exhale, go ahead and push the ground away. Nice. Now from here, I'm going to have you step your right foot outside. Sorry, your right or left foot, whichever side. Let's say right foot. Right foot is going to be, you're going to step that right outside your right hand. Keep your bottom knee down. Push yourself into this hip flexor. Roll your shoulders back, long spine. Go ahead and lift that right hand up to the sky and bring it back down. When you bring it back down, bring your elbow, right elbow to your left wrist, and go ahead and do it again. We're going to do this 7 more times on this side. Good. So that's 7. Take it down. Good. Bring it up. That's 6. 5 more. Good. That's 5. 4 more. Up. That's 4. 3 more. Good. 3. 2 more. Take it under. Raise it up. Good. One more time on this side. Take it down. Take it up. Good. Take that right hand down to the ground. Take this right foot back. Make sure everything's still tabletop position. Left foot forward. Left hand. Bring that elbow underneath to your right wrist and then take it up to the sky. Good. Take it down. Take it up. Good. Woo. Keep breathing through this. So all we're doing here is just prepping the body for the work that we're going to do, all right? Prepping the body for the work we're going to do, and I'm really going to heat you up here in a second. Good. Give me 2 more. So reach it under, reach it up. Give me 1 more. Reach it under and reach it back up. Now from here, stay down here in this position. I'm going to have you pull your core nice and tight. I'm going to have you push your upper body away, kick out to a high plank. I'm going to have you step your left foot, low runner's lunge this time, left foot up, then step your right foot up, land in a squat, reach those biceps up to the sky, biceps next to your ear, stand straight up, tuck your upper abs, squeeze your booty, bring it back down, squat, reach those hands down to the ground, kick or hop your step, step your feet back out, walk it back in, drop your booty, reach those hands up, stand up, good. You're going to give me 3 more of these. Go ahead and come back down, step or hop your feet back, find that high plank, bring your feet back up, one at a time, reach those biceps next to your face, to your ears, squeeze your core, come on up, squeeze your booty at the top, tuck your abs, take it back down, step your feet back, good, walk them back up forward, good, lift your hands up to the sky, come on up, stand, nice job, good job everyone. Now from here, we're going to go ahead and we're going to turn up the heat in here, 30 seconds a piece here. I'm going to start with jumping jacks. We have jumping jacks for 30 seconds. I'm going to have you give me a squat. We're going to open up those hips. We have that for 30 seconds. After we do that, you're going to stand behind your mat. We're going to do crawl outs, pushing your butt back, reaching down to the ground, crawling out to a high plank. Squeeze those quads, squeeze your glutes. Go ahead and come back up, drop your heels, stand back up. Then we're going to stand up and we're going to do some butt kicks. Are you ready to get into this? Here we go in 4 jacks. 3, yes, 2, and 1. Here we go. Jack it out, jack it out, jack it out. Yes, there we go, queens. Come on. Now, I always say to show up as you are. Now this is a jumping jack, right? Fingertips touching at the top. Or you can step out side to side like this. You can even go side to side. If you want, it's up to you. Hey, good. Ha. You have 7 more seconds on the clock right here. 5. 4 seconds left. 3 more. 2. You have 2. 1. Take those feet shoulder width. Squat. Open up your hips. Here we go. So squat. Lift your knee. Take it out. Good. So you're drawing a circle away from your body with your knee. Squat. Open up. Core nice and tight. Yes. Come on. Good. Good. Nice. 5 seconds left. Crawl out. Zip. 4, 3, 2, and 1. Take those feet shoulder width apart. Push your butt back. Hinge forward. Crawl out to a high plank. Now, of course, you can always modify by dropping your knees down. When you stand up, drop your heels. Stand up. Reach those arms above your head. Crawl out. Butt back. Flat back as you crawl out. Squeeze your glutes. Come on up. Reach those hands above your head. Good. 15 seconds here. You're almost there. Keep going. Keep going. Woo! This is the discovery phase. You're discovering where you are. You're discovering your limits. You're discovering how hard you want to push today. 5 seconds left right here. You're going to stand up. Ha! Butt kicks at 4, 3, 2, and 1. Go ahead and come on the ground. Slide hinge forward. Bring your heels to your booty. All we're doing is taking some tension out of those quads right here. Good. Work your arms. Let me see. Athletic arms. Woo! Good. Are you guys enjoying this weather? Oh my goodness, I've been ready for this. I'm ready for this, okay? You have 5 seconds left right here. Jumping jacks one more time. 4, 3, 2, jumping jacks. Let's go. Fingertips touch at the top. Core is nice and tight. Good. Keep breathing. Keep breathing. Yes! Come on. Now, I need you right now. I need you to tap into that queen and king mentality, whatever it is that you want to bring today. I need you to tap into that. I need you to surprise yourself today. I need you to do something that you've never done before. If you're used to doing a modified push-up today, I need you to try at least one full push-up. Take it at your pace. I am the guide. This is your workout. I need you to be the leader and lead your way. You have 5 seconds left. Squat, hip openers in 4, 3, 2, and 1. Squat, hip openers. Good. Push your booty back. Butt goes back. Sit it back. Good. 10 more seconds here. We're going to do crawl outs. And then we have butt kicks. Good. Lift your knee. Open up. Push your hips back. Tuck your upper half to the top. 3, 2, and 1. Go ahead and stand behind your mat. Give me that hinge. Crawl out. High plank. Squeeze everything. Coming back up. Drop your heels. Stand up. Reach those hands above your head. Good. Come on. This playlist today. Now, when I say this playlist today, I'm bringing energy. We are bringing energy today, all right? If it's your first time here, get ready. I need you to buckle up. Woo! Come on. 4, 3, 2, and 1. Go ahead and come on back up. Adjust your crown. Adjust your crown. Slight hinge forward. Shoulders back. Work those arms. Butt kicks. Final 30 seconds here. Come on. Get them up. Get them up. Get them up. Good. Hinge forward. Core tight. Yes, 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 yes. Come on. Heels to your butt. Heels to your butt. Get it up. Get it up. Get it up. You have 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Done. Now, how's that feel? How are we feeling today? I just got to check the other screen really quickly to see how we doing. Whoo, Irina. We in here heavy today. Yes, ma'am. Tyler, I know. Miss T, what is going on? Now, queens, kings, whatever it is that you identify as, you're royalty to me today. So I'm just going to treat you like royalty right now, okay? So what we're going to get into today, we're going to start with a big bang, all right? With a big bang. We usually do 3x3 blocks, 3 exercises, 3 pyramids, 3 rounds through each pyramid, 30 seconds apiece with a 30-second recovery. Today, we're going to do things just a little differently. I'm going to give you 4 movements, and we're going to do them 60 seconds each. We're going to do it twice. Twice. 2 times. We're going to do a cardio, we're going to do a core. We're going to do a cardio, then a core. I'm going to give you lots of different options to do this, all right? Like I said earlier, take it at your pace. If it doesn't feel good for you, pull it back. That is always A-okay to do that. I want you to check in with yourself. We did the mobility, so you know where your limitations are. You know where you're willing to explore. I need you to step out of the I can't, I won't, this is too hard. I need you to be okay and get comfortable being uncomfortable. You're only here just for a little bit. So let me go ahead and pull up the program. All right, it's a little different here. You know when you're not in your same spot, you're like, wait, where's everything at? So what we're gonna start with, we have burpees. So we're gonna start with some burpees, but I'm gonna add something to the burpee. Second portion, we're gonna do a plank and we're gonna do some hip circles. So we're gonna really wind the waist today, so with some hip circles. After we do some hip circles, we're gonna stand up. We're gonna do some curtsy jumps. Whoo, getting those curtsy jumps going on. You can do curtsies, you can give me this extended skater, whatever feels good for you. After we do that, we're gonna do a hollow rock hold. We're gonna do a bit of a roll with it, with a V up. So how this is gonna look, I'm gonna explain. So first thing we have is a burpee. So you can either, same thing that we did in that warm up, you know, plant your hands down, kick out to a high plank, you can hop, step, or walk, you can grab a bench, elevate your upper body, you can do this on your couch, whatever you have, a park bench, whatever you're up, you're at. You're step or hop your feet wider than your hands, put you in a squat position. You're going to stand up. When you stand up, you're going to give me a squat jack. So hands come together. Feet back out to that plank position, to that wide squat, reach back out, step those feet back in, and same thing, give me that squat jack. After we do that, we're gonna come down, you're gonna give me a low plank, so coming down, low plank, first 30 seconds, you're gonna give me hip circles. You're gonna lift your hips up, drop them down, lift your hips, and you're gonna circle. So circling, make sure your legs are straight, quad, you're gonna fire your quads, glutes, then second 30 seconds, take it the other direction. After we do that, I'm gonna stand you up. We have curtsy jumps or curtsy squats. We're gonna give you an extended back leg, reach your inside arm forward. After we do that, you're gonna come down to the ground. We're gonna find a hollow rock hold. So this is gonna be a bit of a challenge, right? This is for that advanced hollow rock hold. If you want it, if not, don't worry, I'm gonna have a modification for you. You're gonna find a hollow rock hold. Hollow rock hold. Lower back is gonna be on the ground, reach those biceps next to your ear, and if your lower back comes off the ground, you're just gonna take your feet up a little higher, reach those arms out, nice long spine, shoulder blades off the ground. What you're gonna do, you're going to roll over. Can you guys still see me? You're gonna roll over, back to your back, then give me a V up. Then you're going to roll back, whoo, give me a V up. Roll forward, V up, roll back, V up. If that's too much for you, you're just gonna hold, give me a V up, take it back out. So V up can be here, your V up can be a single leg, you can use your hands, bring them behind your thighs as assistance, you can do them both and bring them as assistance, or if you're like, you know what, sis, you're tripping right now, sis is tripping, you do a cardio of your choice, but we have 60 seconds of everything. You have 30 seconds to recover, then we're gonna go back in. Are we ready to go in? Are we ready to go in? Ha, here we go, 5 seconds on the clock. Here we go, in 4 seconds, let's go, let's go, let's go, here we go. 3, 2, 1, burpee jacks, go. Burpee jacks, burpee jacks, good. 60 seconds is on the clock. Whew. Nice, nice. Go get it. So do not wait for permission. If you need to recover, you recover, and then you get your ass right back into it. We are not, go. Don't let your distractions around you be a distraction to your workout right here, right now. You gave yourself 50 minutes of self-love, so I need you to see it through. See it all the way through. 30 seconds on the clock. I'm gonna turn the music up just a little because I feel like we need it just. Hey, there we go, come on. Ha. Hey, 20 more seconds on the clock. Let's go. Yes, final 15, pick it up. What is breathless like for you? What is breathless? What does it feel like to you? 10 seconds left. You have 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, come on down. Plank, plank it out. Plank it out, plank it out. We'll hold that plank. And now, hip circles. Hip circles going in one direction here. You can always modify coming down to your knees. You can always bring your knees down to a modified position. Good. Keep those hip circles up. Keep them up, keep them up. Now, what this is going to teach you to do is really squeeze your glutes. Make sure your forearms are parallel. Make a fist with that and really push the outside of your pinkies into the ground. Good. 4, 3, 2, switch the direction. Switch the direction. Hello, core. Hello, core. Nice. You're almost there.
Keep it up, keep it up. Or just hold your plank. Good. You have 10 seconds left on the clock. We pop on up. We have curtsy or skaters. 4, 3, 2, and 1. Go ahead and work yourself back up. Shake it out, cuss me out, do whatever it is that you need to do, and get into those skaters. Good. And now challenge. Can you land in a curtsy? Hey. There we go, there we go. Hey. Come on, go, go, go. Ha. Now remember, back leg is acceptable. You can always keep that back leg extended. Whatever works for you, just work those arms. Hey, ha, nice. 20 seconds on the clock. 40 more seconds to go. You get 30 seconds to recover after this. Whew. Yes. Come on, come on, come on. Yes. Ha. Keep it up. Keep it up, keep it up, keep on going. Ha, 20 seconds left. Now final 15 seconds. I need you to find breathless. Find breathless. Pick it up. I know somebody's like, sis, I'm breathless. I need you to intentionally find breathless. Good. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Ah, put yourself up to the ground. Palmer rock hold. Now let's set this up together. Let's set this up together. Come on down, lay flat. Reach your arms above your head. Lift your shoulders off the ground. Shoulder blades come off the ground. Lift your legs up high, high. Now reach those arms away and slowly lower those legs. Good. Now let's roll. If you can, find a V up. Kick back out. Palmer rock hold. Roll. Good, nice and slow. This is not fast. Woo! Yes. Good job, good job, good job, good job, good job, good job. You're more than halfway there. You're more than halfway there. Remember what I said. You can always just give me a straight knee up. You can always do it for your choice. You can stand up. You can go ahead. You can give me knee pumps. Find a core that works for you. If you heard what I did, my explanation, I didn't say quitting or backing out was an option. Quitting is a habit. If you quit now, you're always going to quit. Don't quit on yourself. You have 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. You have 30 seconds to recover. Yes, that's what I'm talking about. Fix it. Fix the crown. Get it together right now. That's what I'm talking about. Towel down, grab some water. You have 30 seconds to recover. We're going to do this one more time, and then we're going to go through one more block, and then we're going to get into that boxing. Ha. How are we doing? I gotta check the other screen for this. Give me one moment. Whoo! Yes, Donia. Yes, Amber. Alyssa. Amber, you're on here early today. All right. Get ready, Burpee. Coming up with a jack. 5 seconds here. In 4, 3, 2, 1. When I wake up, ha, thank God for life. Look in the mirror, say, bitch, I'm the best. Woo! I need to come into this next round with this energy. You are the best one on this live doing this. Hey, bitch, I'm the best. Ha! Sometimes you just need that little bit of, I need that energy. Woo! Good. Hold it. Hold it. You are now 30 seconds in, 30 seconds to go. Ha. You spent so much more time walking off. Ha. All on Instagram. Hey. Yes. It takes you longer to find a movie to watch on Netflix. And you're ready to quit on yourself right now? Good. 10 seconds left. 4, 3, 2. Come on down by that plank. Good. Come on down. Forearms are parallel. Make a fist. Lift those hips. Drop them down. Ha. Look in the mirror. Say, I'm the best. Ha. Yes. Tell me when I said you were royalty. I need you to come into this with this energy. Ha. Woke up this morning. Look in the mirror. Said, I'm the best and I'm so blessed. Good. 5, 4, 3, 2. Take it in the other direction. Good. Hips up and down, just up and down. Keep breathing. Hello, core. Ha, I hate me too. Good. Remember, you can always modify this. Good. 10 seconds left. You're ready. We're hopping up. We have curtsies in 4, 3, 2, 1. Come on up. Curtsies. Get into it. Get into it, get into it, get into it. Get those curtsies. I've done this on the way. Come on. Good. You're the the best. You're the best. Ha, way too blessed. Waking up this morning was a damn blessing. Ha, good. So now that we've already counted our blessings for the day, which one was where was waking up, two was getting ourselves on here, three was making the commitment to do this, four is doing it. So you have all these blessings coming your way. Stop blocking it with all these excuses. Good. 10 seconds left. Ha. Yes. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Come back down to the mat. Hollow up, hold rolls with the feet up. Let's set it up together. Lay flat. Lift your upper back. Here we go. Roll. Feet up. Come on back. Roll. Feet up. Good. Keep on rolling. Come on. Whew. Roll. Where you want. Good. Nice. Good. Woo. Keep rolling. 20 seconds left of the clock. You have 20 seconds left. Ha! Stop blocking those blessings. Count them. Instead of complaining about how hard it is, how about you celebrate being able? You have 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Recover. Yes. Where you want. That's what I'm talking about. All right. So we're going to finish. We're finishing with a Tabata, right? Tabata, 4 minutes left of work with me, and then we're gonna do some, then you're gonna get into some boxing, all right? So Tabata, 20 seconds of work, 10 seconds to recover. We've been doing Tabatas all week, so I know you're ready for this. Are we ready to get into this? So the first thing that we have, we're gonna do high knees. High knees. How this is gonna look? High knees, pump your arms, get your knees up. A lot of times when we do high knees, we think it's a jog. You're really actively trying to get your booty up. You have 20 seconds to do this. Push the effort, respect your 10 second recovery. Part two of this, you're gonna come down to the ground. Coming all the way down to the ground, you're gonna lay nice and flat. You're gonna come up to the side crunch, be up, or whatever feels good for you, side crunch, be up. Lift up, rotate your body to the side. Two movements. High knees, and we're getting that V up, that bicycle rotation. Here we go. Whew, and I got a song for us. Are we ready? 4 minutes. I know you guys have 4 minutes in you. Big inhale in and exhale out. Here we go. 3, 2, and 1. Get those knees up. Get those knees up. Get those knees off the ground. Get them up. Get them up. Get them up. Get them up. Yes. Get them up. Now, like I said, respect. Push the effort. Respect the recovery. Push the effort. Respect the recovery. Good. Woo. 10 more seconds. 5, 4, 3. Get those knees up. 2, 1. Rest. Come on down to the ground. Come on down. Lay flat. Ha. Good. 5 seconds. So we come up, twist and turn. 3, 2, 1. Let's go. Twist and turn. Come on up. Twist and turn. Come on up. Good. Good. 20 seconds right here. 20 seconds. 4 minutes of work is all I need from you. Ha. 4 minutes. Woo! And you guys know I'm playing this song. 4, 3, 2, 1. Go ahead, work yourself up. You're about to lose your mind. Ha! 4, 3. High knees, let's go. Get them knees up, get them up, get them up, get them up, get them up. Pump those arms. This is still appropriate. You can slow it down. You have to. Hey! Come on. Whew. 10 seconds. Get those knees up, 10 seconds left. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Come on down to the ground. Come on down to the ground. Lay flat. Lay flat. Inhale through your nose, exhale out. Here we go. 4, 3, 2, 1. Yes, yes. Twist and turn. Twist and turn that body. Lift, twist. Yes. 10 seconds. Come on. 9 seconds left. 8 seconds. 7. All the way to the end. 4, 3, 2, 1. Come on up. Now, I'm going to switch this next one up. We're switching this next part of Tabata up. Take your feet a little bit apart. Take your hands straight to the ground. Frog jumps. Here we go. Let's go. Frog jumps. Frog jumps. Come on. Good. Good. Yes. You know, yes, I switched it up on you. We know something different. It's like life. You get thrown something at you, you own it. You smile at it. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Go down to the ground. 10 more seconds left here. We come 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Let's go. Recovery is a recovery. It is not a vacation. Yes. Woo. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Come back up. 5 seconds here. Take those feet out, shoulder width apart, touch the ground. Come up in 3, 2, 1. Now, you can always just stand straight up. You can always stand up and pop up on your toes. Make sure those knees are going out. Make sure that your heels are married to the earth. Come on, let's go, let's go, let's go. This is your final effort. Final effort and you're done. Find breathless, less than 10 seconds. Yes, you have 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Is this worth it, losing your job? Here we go. 3, 2, 1. Let's go. Side crunch. Side crunch. Side crunch. You have 20 seconds left. Come on. Come on, come on, come on, come on. Whoo. Yes. Hey. Man, I was ready for this song to come on. I should put it earlier on the playlist. Good. 5 seconds left. 4, 3, 2, 1. Yes. Clap it up for you. I need you to validate yourself right now. Just because you are by yourself does not mean that you are isolated. Isolated is a mentality. Look at this community. Look how we show up for each other. Everybody on here sweating. We're all doing the same thing. We might not be together, but isolation is a mentality. I'm going to go ahead and hand this over to my friend Teddy. Please, please, please give him as much love and respect as you guys usually give me. I appreciate you all so, so much. We'll go ahead and turn it down so we can pass it off. All right, you're ready. Come on up.
All right, girl, let's do it. I need to take it.
It's just a little microphone. This is my boy Teddy, you guys, and his beautiful model, Neusha. This is her gym. So we have 20 minutes left of work, and I'm handing it over.
All right, guys. So here's what we got going on today. We are going to move into a shadow boxing flow. This flow is going to be a focus on footwork, defense, and punches. So we're going to start nice and easy with some easy footwork and punching flows. This is going to be my demonstrator. She's going to go through the movements while I'm explaining everything to you guys. So we're going to begin with the jab. She's going to stay weighted on the rear foot while pacing forward on the lead foot, firing the jab hand out, and then pacing back to her neutral position. Pacing again on that foot, coming back to the neutral position, pacing in again. So we're going to continue that flow of working in and out with that jab, pacing on that lead foot, and firing. So while this is happening, guys, you want to make sure that you're balanced. Can I move to the center a little more? You guys want to make sure you're balanced, that your stance is proper, that you have adequate distance between your lead foot and your rear foot. You're taking just a small pace on the lead foot while you fire that jab, and you're fully extending that jab hand all the way out. That rear hand is tucked while you're making that movement. Now, going into the second phase of the movement, we're going to move into stepping back on the cross. So as we pace forward on the lead foot, we come back to the neutral stance, and we're going to pace back on the rear foot and fire the cross, and then come back to the neutral stance. So jab, neutral stance, cross, neutral stance. Continuing that flow, pacing forward on the jab, pacing backwards on the cross. Building from this flow, we want to pay attention to the rear foot. As she fires that cross, you'll notice that she turns the hip, the heel and the toe line up and are pointed forward, and her shoulder is coming forward, no longer being her rear shoulder, but now coming to the lead. Moving into the third stage of this flow, we're gonna fire the jab. Back to the cross. Back to neutral. This time when we fire the hook, we're going to pace to the lead side and then back to neutral. So jab, neutral, cross, neutral, hook, neutral. Continuing that flow. You'll notice that as she fires the hook, she takes a slight pace to the outside. Also, you guys need to notice that the lead hip, as she's firing that hook, she's turning that lead hip. The toes are turning so that they're pointing away from the target. Keep it up, guys. We're just going to keep it up for just a few more seconds here. We're going to move into the next flow. All right, guys. So we're just going to move back to holding our fight stance just like so. Now we're going to move into some basic movements and punches with our hands. So when we fire, we're going to fire jab and pace forward. Then we're going to fire cross and take a small pace forward on our rear foot. And jab, take one more pace forward on the lead foot. Then we're going to do the same thing going backward. So jab, small pace on the lead foot. Cross, small pace on the rear foot. Jab, small pace on the lead. So in real time, we're going to go one, two, one. One, two, one. One, two, one. One, two, one. Continuing that flow. Coming forward, firing one, two, one. Stepping to the rear, firing one, two, one. Oh, I think you lost music. Oh, we're getting there. All right, guys. All right. So notice that as she's firing, she's taking small paces on each foot corresponding with the hand that she's firing with. Meaning when she fires a jab, she paces on the lead foot, fires the cross, paces on the rear foot. Now we're going to change the flow into moving laterally. So beginning towards our lead side, with our lead foot, we're going to fire a jab and take a pace. Cross, we're going to bring our rear foot across towards that lead foot. Jab, taking another pace, and then finishing in our neutral stance. Then we're going to go towards the rear side, leading with the rear foot. We're going to fire the jab, cross, jab, and then finish in our neutral stance. So real time, we're going one, two, one. One, two, one. One, two, one. One, two, one. Continuing that flow. During the duration of this, she's maintaining a proper fight stance. Her rear hand is tucked. Her arms are up, guarding the body, guarding the lower half of the face. Moving so that her feet are adequate distance apart so that she's balanced during the duration of these movements. Keep it up, keep it up. Good looking flow right here, guys. We got a few more seconds until we move into our next flow. Three, two, one. All right, guys. So this next movement is going to be slightly more complex, but pay close attention. We're going to pace on the lead foot, moving to our neutral stance. Our next pace, we're going to fire the jab. We'll then take a small pivot, cutting that angle, putting our weight on the lead foot as we turn, and then we're going to fire one, two. Cutting back, then we're going to pace back, one pace, two pace. So pace, pace and jab, pivot, one, two, pivot back, two paces to the rear. So pace, jab, pivot, one, two, pivot back, pace, pace. Pace, jab, pivot, one, two, pivot back, pace, pace. We're going to continue that flow, guys. Pace, jab, pivot, one, two, pivot back, pace, pace. Beautiful, guys. As we keep that flow up, I want you to pay attention to a few key things here. Every time she paces, she always ends in her neutral stance where she's nice and balanced. Where she's balanced, she has power in her strikes. Also, another key thing about it is she is breathing out as she is throwing her strikes. This is applying power into those strikes. Keep it up, guys. Just a few more seconds until we go into the next flow. Thank you. 1. All right, guys, moving into our next flow. We're going to be in our fight stance here. So we're going to take one pace forward. We're going to pivot towards, continue that flow. Pace, inward pivot, pivot back, step. Pace, inward pivot, pivot back, step. Pace, inward pivot, pivot back, step. Continuing that flow right there, guys, and then we're going to have punches in just a few seconds. And adding our punches, we're going to jab, pivot, cross, hook, pivot, pace back, jab, pivot, cross, hook, pivot, pace back. Continue that flow. Jab, pivot, cross, hook, pivot back, pace back. Moving in, firing a punch, changing position, firing two more punches, moving back and getting out of range. This is a basic fighting formula, guys. We're going to continue that flow for a few more seconds until we move into our next one. Make sure we're breathing into this, guys. Make sure that we are taking our time with these movements, focusing more on the form than the speed. Three, two, one. All right, guys, now we're going to go ahead and mix a few defensive movements together. So for the first range of defensive movements, we're going to begin with rolls. As we begin rolling, I'm going to imagine that I'm drawing a U with my forehead, begin crouching down, shrugging my shoulders in slightly. I'm going to pivot on that rear foot just a bit so I have the range of motion to create that U and come back to my neutral stance. Then I'm going to roll back the other way. Roll to the lead, roll to the rear. Roll to the lead, roll to the rear. Roll to the lead. Now when you roll, guys, what's happening is you're quickly clearing a limb that is flying at you and getting right around it so that you're able to counter. So from here, we're going to add our footwork. So we're going to roll to the lead, one, two, and then we're going to pace on the lead and then finish here. Roll, roll, roll and pace. Roll, roll, roll and pace. Roll, roll, roll and pace. And then we're going to add punches, guys. We're going to keep this flow up. So as we're adding our punches, we're going to begin by firing two hooks. The first hook she's going to fire as she's pacing towards the next step, and then she's going to finish with her lead hook. So restarting from the top, we're going to roll, roll, roll and hook, and then finish with our hook. Roll, roll, roll and hook, and then finish with our hook on the top. Roll, roll, roll and hook. Finish with our hook on the top. Roll, roll, roll and hook. Finish with your hook on the top and continue that flow, guys. Looking good, guys. Flowing smoothly in time. Take your time, nice and slow with these movements. As you begin to feel comfortable, let's go ahead and pick up the pace just slightly. Three, two, one. Going into our next flow, we're going to move into slips. So I'm going to slip to the lead side, slightly pivoting on my rear. Slip to the rear side. Slip to the lead. Slip to the rear. We're going to flow right there. Just subtle slips, guys. Keep in mind, boxing is just a game of inches. So I'm just slipping my head just a few inches off of the center line. I'm not bending all the way down here. Nice and easy flow. Make sure you feel comfortable and balanced during this movement. Now we're going to add our next piece. So when we flip to the lead side, we're going to pace on that foot and pivot. So slip to the lead, pace, pivot. Slip, pace, pivot. Slip, slip and pace, pivot. Pivot, slip and pace, pivot. Sorry, sorry, we're on top of each other. So slow it down, guys. So slip, when we slip to the lead, slip, pivot, pivoting back. Then we're gonna slip to the rear, bringing our lead foot in, back to our neutral stance. So again, slip, slip at pace, pivot, pivoting back, slipping to the rear, I'm bringing that lead foot back in, and I'm back in my neutral fight stance. Slip, slip and pace, pivot, pivot back, slip and pace to the inside, back to neutral. Slip, slip and pace, pivot, pivot back, slip and pace, back in my neutral fight stance. Keep that flow up, guys. Looking good, guys. Just a few more seconds and we're going to move into the next flow. Three, two, one. All right, guys, now we're going to dumb down the footwork just a little bit. We're going to stay in position in our fight stance. We're going to begin with the jab. Firing the jab in position. When we retract that hand, we're going to fire the cross, pivoting on the rear foot, cross. So we're going to stay right there. Jab, pivot into that cross. Jab, pivot into that cross. Jab, pivot into that cross. Make sure you're rotating. Can I have you step over to the center again, please? So as she's firing the cross, that rear shoulder's coming forward. That hip is turning. Heel to toe is lined up, pointing at the target. Retracting back to the neutral stance at the end of that punch. Jab, cross. Both hands are fully extended straight to the target. Good work, guys. Good work. Next position here, we're going into the jab, cross, hook, jab, cross, hook. Make sure that we're rotating during the duration of those punches. Your power comes from your rotation, through your breathing, through your balance. One, two, three. Make sure you feel that body rotating. The hips should rotate. The torso should rotate behind the hips. And final piece of that. Jab, cross, hook, rear uppercut. Jab, cross, hook, rear uppercut. Jab, cross, hook, rear uppercut. And notice the stance is tight. The hand's not coming down here to fire the uppercut. It's in the guard and then coming up through it. That uppercut is a beautiful weapon to split the guard. Looking good, guys. We almost there. And three, two, one. All right, guys, so our next flow, still in a stationary position, we're gonna add some defense. So we're gonna fire one, two, slip, slip. One, two, slip, slip. One, two, slip, slip. One, two, slip, slip. Slip, slip. Very good. One, two, slip, slip. Nice and balanced. Her head is not exceeding her rear foot, and it's not exceeding the lead foot as she slips. So she's able to maintain balance and get back to her neutral stance quickly. Nice straight punches, good body rotation. Looking good. We got a few more seconds until we add the next piece. Three, two, one. All right, so we're firing one, two, slip, slip, hook, cross. One, two, slip, slip, hook, cross. One, two, slip, slip, hook, cross. Keeping that flow nice and easy, guys. Take your time. Make sure you're breathing through the punches. Make sure you're just slipping just a few inches off the center line. We're not bending very deep, just far enough to get away from the punch. Adding the next piece in 3, 2, 1. So starting from the top, we go 1, 2, slip, slip, hook, cross, roll, roll. 1, 2, slip, slip, hook, cross, roll, roll. This is a combination of punching and defensive movements. 1, 2, slip, slip, hook, cross, roll, roll. 1, 2, slip, slip, hook, cross, roll, roll. Let's take our time. 1, 2, slip, slip, hook, cross, roll, roll. 1, 2, slip, slip, hook, cross, roll, roll. Adding the final strikes, you guys, starting from the top. 1, 2, slip, slip, hook, cross, roll, roll, hook, hook. 1, 2, slip, slip, hook, cross, roll, roll, hook, hook. Continuing that flow. Slip, slip, hook, cross, roll, roll, hook, hook. Good flow, guys. Stay in position. Feel balanced. Make sure that as you are rolling, as you are slipping, there are just small, subtle movements, just enough to get out of the way. Nice and good balance in the stance. Breathing through those punches. Just a few more seconds. Three, two, one. All right, guys, final flow here. We're gonna go fire. 1, 2, continue there. 1, 2, small paces in position. 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1,2, 1,2, continuing that flow. All right, final sequence here, guys. We're going to move into that shoe shine. So we're going to start with uppercuts, continuous, nice and fast, picking up that speed. Who can do it faster? Can you should beat coach? Who's got the fastest hands? I've got the fastest hands. Keep that flow, guys, just a few more seconds. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and time. Beautiful work, guys. I hope we had some fun today. This was Coach Temo with Puerto Rican Boxing Club and the infamous Queen Nusha in the house. I hope you guys had some fun today. But with that being said, we got to give it back to Brittany. Brittany, please.
Thank you guys so much for joining us. It was such a pleasure having you. I hope you enjoyed it. You can find Coach Ted Mo on Instagram at Coach Ted Mo and at Boricua Boxing. I will tag it here at the bottom. And also, if you check on Instagram, it's all tagged on the page. Thank you guys so much. Love you. I appreciate you. I'll see you tomorrow, Saturday, 9 a.m. Booty and Bands. See you guys soon. Bye-bye.